Dear Promising Trader, welcome to Understanding Moving Averages. This is Alex from PromisingTrader.com and today we will discuss about moving averages. They can be used for trading stocks, forex, crypto and everything that you can trade. Moving averages are an indicator that can be used with other indicators or alone to create trading strategies. Moving averages are those lines that you see on my screen when I use TradingView during my daily videos here on YouTube, and are those lines that overlap the candlesticks. If you are in the Promising Traders tribe, you surely have received my personal strategies and you know what I'm talking about. By the way, it's completely free and you can join anytime. Before continuing, here's what we're going to talk about in this tutorial. What is a moving average? What are moving averages used for? How to calculate the moving average? Popular types of moving averages, the Fibonacci variation, EMA versus SMA, in other words, exponential moving averages versus simple moving average, simple EMA crossover strategy. What is a moving average? A moving average is just a point in the chart. It represents the average closing price of a number of candles prior to that point. Despite being usually the closing price, it could also be for other reference of a candle, such as the high, the low, or the opening prices, anything. The number of candles prior to that point is called period, and it is up to the analyst to choose what period to display in the screen. For instance, if we have a moving average for the previous 10 candles, we will have a point in the present chart that represents the average of the closure price of those previous 10 candles. In this case, to calculate the point, we need to have at least 10 older candles to be displayed, and without them, the system will not display anything. If the moving average is a line, it's thanks to connecting these points between each other. What are moving averages used for? As I mentioned in the previous section, moving averages are used for technical analysis. Usually, they are used to identify targets, for instance, up to what price holding or selling, where to enter and when to exit a trading position. They work very well only when the market trends. In fact, they are also good at telling you whether the market is bearish or bullish. If the price is above the moving averages, it means that the trend is bullish, while if it is below, the trend is bearish. And they tell you this even better if you use more than one. In fact, if the one with the shorter time, for instance a 10 moving averages, is above a longer one, for instance a 50 moving average, and the price is above both moving averages, this is a stronger confirmation that the trend is bullish, while the opposite would define a bear market. Moving averages, on the other hand, are totally useless when the market is not trending and is moving laterally, as they keep crossing each other and it is impossible to make predictions based on them. My very first strategy shared within the Promising Traders tribe is exactly based on moving averages and candlesticks. Always use candlesticks to find when to enter or exit trades. At the end of this video, I will also share one strategy with you, which is based on one moving average and the improved version with two. Right now, I have linked a card to this video. It is how to set up TradingView with the free account, configuring two moving averages, my candle scanner, and I also show you how to set up a paper trading account so that you can already begin to make practice with buying and selling without risking real money, yet playing in the real markets. Now, because I never recommend products and services that I don't use myself and I am satisfied about, I would also recommend to invest some of your money in the Steve Neeson Swing Trading course. The link is in the description. It provides with several strategies for swing traders. They all work. And here we are on how to calculate the moving average. Before I give you the formula, I must explain that there are multiple types of moving averages, and I will only explain how the simple moving average is calculated. If you ever need to calculate moving averages, I would always advise to use TradingView Pinescript, which comes with these formulas and save lots of time. But for the majority of the common traders, this is just interesting information, as we really don't mind too much knowing exactly how to calculate them. We want to know how to use them. Said so. As I was explaining before, we can calculate the moving average of the opening price, the closing price, the high, or the low of each candle. Usually we go with the closing price, but we can also make an average of the extension of one candle and calculate that moving average. The formula is very simple. Let's pretend that we want to calculate a 3 simple moving average, also known as SMA. We need to collect the 3 previous closing prices, which in this example would be $5, $6 and $4. The average is simply calculated by making the sum of these 3 values and then divided by 3, which is the amount of values that we have summed together, basically the classical arithmetic average. So, let's do it together. 5 plus 6 plus 4 equals 15, which is divided by 3 and equals 5, which is the moving average of these previous 3 candles. Even if I won't provide you with the formula, I think it is necessary to spend a few words on the exponential moving average, also known as EMA, which is the one that you see me using. I solely use EMAs during my technical analysis, but it's a matter of preferences, as you will see shortly. The only difference between the EMA and the SMA is that we give more weight to the more recent price. Basically, there is a ratio, and instead of summing the exact value of each previous closing price like we did for the SMA, we diminish the value of the farther candles using this ratio, hence giving them less importance in the calculation of the moving average thanks to an exponentially lower importance or weight based on the age of the candle. Popular types of moving averages. Normally, traders tend to use more or less the same moving averages. They base this usage according to several factors, which in fact make it impossible to provide you with the one magic setting that will make you millionaire, such as use these two moving averages in this particular time frame and you will always win. That's impossible. And I would advise caution if you ever stumble upon someone who tells you to do so. However, choosing between the 10, the 20, the 30, the 50 and the 200 moving averages, you will find the combination that better works for your purpose. This I explain with a practical example on Apple in one of my strategy videos for the Promising Traders Tribe. Usually, having different values produces different lines. For instance, the smaller the number, the closer the line will tend to stay to the candle. While the greater the value, the more probabilities that at a certain point the price will be far away from the moving average. Prices tend to eventually get close to moving averages. When we have a short-term moving average, we should expect that the price will separate from it for a shorter time than from a longer moving average, as they eventually will get again together before separating again. The farther the price is from a short moving average, the more likely that the market in that moment is either oversold or overbought, meaning that it will soon get closer to the moving average by either moving straight up or down where the moving average is, or go sideways until the moving average catches up with it. In fact, all the strategies based on moving averages that I know are based on the distance and position of the moving averages between each other and with the price. As I said at the beginning of this section, the most popular moving average lengths are 10, 20, 30, 50, 100 and 200. If you have watched any of my technical analysis, you may have noticed that I use 8, 13, 21, 34, 55 and 233, which are the Fibonacci variation. Regarding Fibonacci, you can read and see many things online for free, and I am also sure that you know the famous shell shape with the spiral, which represents exactly what the Fibonacci ratio is. Basically, these numbers that I use belong to the Fibonacci sequence. Fibonacci was an Italian mathematician who happened to find this ratio that apparently appeals us and is present in everything within our universe, from shapes of various things to music and sounds that appeal the human beings. I would invite you to search Fibonacci online, as this is well beyond the purpose of this tutorial and I am not an expert in the topic, but it is fascinating to simply search for images and music based on the Fibonacci sequence. All we need to know is that the Fibonacci sequence can be calculated by adding 1 to 1. Then the sum of these two numbers, being 2, added to the previous number in the sequence, which is 1, meaning 3. Then adding 3 to the previous number of the sequence, which is 2, giving 5. And I think you got the idea. In fact, the next number in the sequence would be 8, 5 plus 3, and so on, so forth. EMA versus SMA. There is no real winner between these two. Every trader has a favorite strategy. Every strategy may have a particular type of moving average or set of them. As I mentioned before, whenever you want to make your analysis, it is wise to test different types and different lengths of moving averages so that you can better find which one gives you the best reading. Often, you can find out that on a particular security, a particular set of moving averages work better than others, but it's all very relative and needs testing. Usually, the exponential moving average tends to be more reactive because it is more influenced by the more recent price actions, while the simple moving average tends not to be as nervous and possibly filters some noise that the exponential moving average doesn't ignore. You can find an example on Apple with both moving averages being set to 8, and the simple moving average, the orange one, is not as sensible as the cyan one, which is the 8 EMA. The exponential moving average responded to the peak and the fall, while the simple moving average just skipped it. Simple trading strategy. And finally, we are at the long-weighted strategy. I believe this is the simplest strategy that you can find, and it really requires one single moving average, which makes it perfect if you have a free account on TradingView, which you can do through the link in the description if you haven't already done so. However, because with TradingView and a free account, you can have up to 4 indicators, one being the volume and one my candle scanner, if you are in the Promising Traders tribe, I would recommend using 2 moving averages, specifically the 233 or 200, according to what you prefer, EMA, and the 55 or 50 EMA, because 2 moving averages will give you a better idea of the general trend. The strategy consists in entering a trade whenever a candle closes crossing the 55 EMA and either buying or selling according to the direction of the candle. Where, if the candle is red, crosses and closes below the 55 EMA, you would sell short the market. Or, if it is green, crosses and closes above the 55 EMA, you would buy or go long. By the way, I show you how to place these orders in the video in the card above. The next step before confirming the order is to set a stop loss. This needs to be at the opposite end of the candle that crossed the 55 EMA or a few ticks farther. Your stop loss is the maximum amount of money that you are willing to lose, and also remember that you want to keep an estimated 3-to-1 ratio, meaning that your stop loss should be 1/3 of where you foresee the price to go. This is the strategy, as simple as that. The 55 EMA strategy should be used on relatively long time frames. Not that it doesn't work in 1 minute time frame. The only problem is that you have commissions, spread, and maybe a crossover of the 55 EMA in 1 minute time frame gives you a very low profit, if any, as it can be eaten by your broker's commission. I advise to use this strategy on a 3 hours at least. My favorite is the 6 hours. As I said before, because we can do better than that, why not going for the more complex strategy that works exactly the same but gives you more chances to win? I have elaborated this 55 EMA strategy a little bit from the original swing trading strategy and have combined it with the 233 EMA. However, you can choose to merely use the original strategy with only the 55 EMA or both 55 and 233. Up to you, really. But with two moving averages, you are better at finding the trend and you never want to go against the trend. It is very easy to find the trend and where the price is compared to it. For the trend to be bullish, you need the price be above all the moving averages and the long moving average to be below the short one. In this instance, we are talking about from top to bottom, seeing the current price, the 55 EMA and the 233 EMA. If the price is above the 55 EMA only, and the 233 EMA is above them, the trend may be bearish, but it is then when you want to enter. I will explain in a bit. The same is true for a bear market, where obviously the price should be below both EMAs and the 233 being on top. In simple words, the improved strategy consists in finding what side of the 233 EMA the price is and where the 55 EMA is compared to both price and 233 EMA. As soon as the price is between the 233 EMA and the 55 EMA, you have the condition about to be created. In fact, the crossover of the 55 EMA in that case will confirm the trend. For instance, I have an example with Ethereum US dollar right here for you to look at, where the price of Ethereum was approaching the 233 EMA, the dark red line, crossing the 55 EMA, the green line. Because both the 55 and the price were below the 233 EMA, we have confirmation that this was still a bear market. Checking more timeframes and having consistent evidence that the trend is bearish is a good idea as it increases your probabilities of success. But to confirm that it was going to continue being a bear market, I had to wait for the price to drop below the 55 EMA so that we had the correct bear market order where the 233 EMA is on top, the 55 EMA, and then the price are below it. The strategy is always based on the crossover of the 55 EMA. In this case, we need to wait for a red candle that opens above the 55 EMA and closes below it. If it is a short candle, it is even better so that the stop loss is minimal. For instance, in this image, we can see that Ethereum went below the 55 EMA, but it did not close below it. Therefore, this is not a valid entry point for shorting. In other words, selling Ethereum with the intent to make money on a bear market. The opportunity arrived here, where you can see that the candle closed below the 55 EMA, and we also have a confirmation from the Hanging Man a few candles before, where the Hanging Man itself was confirmed to be a reversal by the next candle, which closed below its opening price. This is a requisite for the Hanging Man to confirming a reversal of the trend. Because the alignment of all the events occurred, we can now enter the market with our short position. We can do it after the candle is closed, but I like to do it a little before the candle is closed, where I see that there is no likelihood for the candle to close above the 55 EMA anymore. You can choose to wait. We place our short order at $224.10 and then wait until a reversal signal, which in this case was provided by the piercing pattern, appears, and then we buy Ethereum back. Your profit for this trade was 17%. The downside of this strategy is that you must find the perfect alignment of all these events, and it takes a long time, which is why if you have a paid account on TradingView, you can set alerts which will notify you every time the situation is forming and you won't waste time searching for these events manually. And this is how you make money with a set of rules that you must follow and never break at all costs. Every deviation from your rules is considered gambling and no longer a business of making money through trading. You must always consider that there is a certain level of randomness in this business, and sometimes things simply don't go as expected, which is why you must always have your stop loss in place. It could also be mental instead of a physical order, as long as you close your position if the price goes to your designated stop loss value. Be aware that sometimes this strategy would not work due to a non-trending market. This is part of the risk, but we have confirmed in my first video of this series that even other businesses imply many risks. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and that you will be able to apply it in your paper trading so that you can become an expert before you play with real money. In the next lesson, we will discuss about MACD.